Hello students, so today we will continue our self-practice 11D. So this first question, 1A. What will be the other angles of the right angle isosceles triangle? So in the right angle isosceles triangle, one angle is 90 degree and the other two sides are equal. This is a right angle isosceles triangle from the angle ABC in which B is 90 and side angle B is equal to AC. So in an isosceles triangle, so angle opposite to equal sides are equal. So angle opposite to side AB is C and angle opposite to side BC is A. So these two angles are equal. So angle opposite to sides are equal. So this is X, so this is also X. So now we apply the angle sum property of triangle. Now we can write A triangle AB C and the A plus angle B. Now put the values of angle A is X and angle B is 90 degree given and angle C is X. So X plus X will be 2X and transfer this 90 to the right hand side. So 180 minus 90. Now X is equal to 180 minus 90 is 90 divided by 2. When 2 is transferred to the right hand side, so this will divide the right hand side term. So 2 will be 45 by 90. So the value of X is equal to 45. So in this regard, what is the other angle of the isosceles triangle? So we got angle A equals to angle C equals to 45. That other angles we got. So other angles of the right angle of the isosceles triangle is this. Can you draw an obtuse angle isosceles triangle? No, not possible. Because if you draw more than 90, so obtuse angle isosceles triangle means yes we can draw. So here if these two angles, obtuse right angle, can you draw obtuse angle isosceles triangle? Yes, obtuse angle isosceles triangle we can draw. So just what we have to do, just we have to increase the angle. Now this angle will be 120 degree and this two will be 30 degree. That is also possible. Yes, we can draw. Yes, we can draw from this angle isosceles triangle. This angle isosceles triangle can be drawn. Of this angle isosceles triangle can be drawn. So here. Yeah. Yes. Okay, so B, yes. So B not B, right? Yes. Obtuse angle isosceles triangle can be drawn. Now we move to the next question. Question number 2. In the question number 2, the vertical angle of isosceles triangle is the size of each of its base angle. Again, you apply the isosceles triangle property. Question number 2. Look at that. This is our isosceles triangle. So in isosceles triangle, the vertical angle is 90 degree. And we have to find the base angle. What is the each of its base angle? So this is isosceles, this side is equal. So this base angle is what? X and X. Again apply the angle sum property of triangle. You get X plus 110 equals to 180 degree. These are angle sum property of triangle. Angle sum is 45 angle sum property of triangle. Angle sum property of triangle. Now you get the answer of X. Now you solve it. Now we move to the question number 3. In the angle ABC, two sides are equal. And in triangle ABC, there is a triangle ABC. A, B, C. That is question number 3. So in triangle A, B, C, AB equals to AC. Two sides are given. And angle A equals to 50 degree. Again, what is the measure of angle B? So that again, you can take X again apply the Laplace property, 180 minus 80, 100. So 2x is equal to 100 degree. Now then x will be 50 degree. So here we got x will be equal to 50 degree. X will be equal to 50 degree. By what reason? Angle sum property of triangle that we have to apply. First we consider the triangle, right? In triangle ABC. Angle A plus angle B plus angle C equals to 180 degree. This is an angle sum property. Now put the value and get the answer. You will get the answer. In triangle A, BC. So name the pair of sides which are equal. So side of the equal angles are equal. So what did I get? Angle A equals to angle B. Now in triangle A, B, C, what to write? Angle A equals to angle B. Angle A equals to angle B. Reason? Side opposite equal angles are equal. So side opposite angle is what? B, C. Side opposite triangle A is what? BC. So you write BC. And side opposite triangle B is what? AC. Side opposite triangle B is what? AC. So BC equals to BC. Reason? Side opposite to equal angles. Side opposite to equal angles. Side opposite equal angles are equal. The figure given here, there is a triangle in this. So the triangle you can see, there is a triangle. So in this we have to prove that NB equals to NC. To prove, in this we have to prove NB equals to NC. That is actually to prove equal. So this only we can prove equal if we prove that angle opposite to the simple sides are equal. Angle opposite to NB is this angle. And angle opposite to NC is this angle. If any number these two angles are equal, so we can say NB equals to NC. Now first we calculate these angles, how we can calculate. So this is the C. So this is vertical angle, this is an isosceles triangle between triangle A and C. What we have to do? In triangle A and C, AN equals to AC. AN equals to what? This implies that. So angle opposite to equal sides are equal. So angle opposite to A and B is equal to C. And angle C equals to angle N. Now we find these angles. This we can take as a given. Okay. Now we apply the angle property of triangle. Now we can write here angle A plus angle A and C. Here angle C means what? Angle ACN. Here angle C means we can write angle ACN. ACN. And here angle N means, so angle N means angle ANC. Angle ANC. Angle A and C plus angle A, C, N equals to 180. Now we put the value. Reason angles of property of triangle vertex 2, angles of property of triangle. Reason angles of property of triangle. Now you put the value and change it to plus angle A and C plus angle ACN. Both we write angle in terms of ACN. So angle A CN plus angle ACN equals to 180. Reason from where I have written this. Reason for this I'll write the next line. Reason for this is what from equation 1. So from equation 1 I have got this angle A and C is equal to angle A and C equals to angle ACN. So that's the substitution of the place of angle A and C angle ACN. Now twice of angle ACN plus angle ACN gives you twice of angle ACN. So angle ACN and the ACN equals to 180 minus 80. ACN. Divided by 64 degrees. So angle AC and I got 64 degrees. So when this we got angle AC and this we got 64 degrees. So this is also 64 degrees. This is proof. Now we have to calculate this angle. And we have to calculate this angle. So see, this angle is also 180 minus. So linear linear. So what do you like? This we got angle AC. Equation we can take 64 degrees. Now angle B and C plus angle A and C. Angle B and C plus angle A and C. Angle B and C plus angle A and C. First of all, 180 degrees. Reason? Linear pair. What reason? Linear pair is linear pair means angle between a straight line. See, this is a straight line AB. On this two angle is made, angle A and C and angle B and C. Both are on the straight line. So here some will be 180 degrees. So angle B and C and plus angle A and C measurement we got 64 plus 2 180. So what angle B and C equals to 180 minus 64. So when you subtract 64 from 180 we get 116 will be that angle we got. Okay. So that it will make a decision. This we got 116. Now you calculate this angle. So see how you get this that angle. Now you write angle BCF plus angle ACF plus angle plus angle ACK plus angle ACK equals to common what? Angle on the straight line. So angle on the straight line. Angle on the straight line is something like straight line. So angle on the straight line. So these three angles are given on the straight line and the sum of the straight angle. Sum of the straight angle is 180 degrees. So if you add all these three angles which is greater than straight line, the sum is 180 degrees. So what you write? Angle BCN, which you have to calculate, plus angle ACN equals 64, plus angle ACP 84 equals to 180 degrees. Now angle BCN equals to 180 degrees minus 2. Add 84 and 64. 80 plus 60 is 140. 140 plus 8 is 48. Minus 140 is 48. So what you got in the BCN equals to 148, 42 degrees. 40 degrees. Well, BCN you got 42 degrees. Now, we calculate angle B, not straight angle. Now angle ACK, equals to angle A plus angle B. These are exterior angle. Because exterior angle of triangle equals to the because angle ACK is exterior angle for the triangle ABC. For triangle ABC, this angle ACK is the exterior angle, and the sum of the interior exterior interior angle is this one angle C, and the sum of the interior opposite angles. These interior opposite angles are A and B. So the interior opposite angle sum is equal to the exterior angle. So what you write? 84 equals to angle A 52 plus angle B plus angle B. So here 180 minus 40, 32. What? Subtraction. Its value is 32. Okay, 50, 180, 32. Now here you also know what? So angle B is equals to 84 minus 52. So angle B. Now this you can take the question. Now when you compare this angle BCN also equals to 180 degrees and this also becomes 180 degrees. So in this triangle both these angles are same. So now you can say this is the isosceles triangle. Now from question 5 and 6 on comparing question 4 and 5. 4 and 5 both angles are same. BCN and B both are same. Okay. So, angle now in triangle B and C, now in triangle B and C, angle B equals to angle B. BC, yeah. Yeah. From equation 4 and 5. From equation 4 and 5. So this is like that. Side of which to equal angles are equal. So side of which to MOB is NC. What you write? NC equals to MB. NC equals to MB. What you write? True. This is what you put in. This is what you put. Side opposite to equal angles are equal. Side opposite to equal angles are equal. Side opposite to equal angles okay. Now see the question number 6. What is the question? Here is a triangle. A, B, C. And this is the side. This angle is 30 degree. And this is BC. And this angle is 40 degree. Okay. Here AB goes to AC given. What? This side is equal to this side given. To prove BD equals to BC. To prove BD equals to BC. Again, the same thing. AB equals to BC. Where well, these two base angles are equal. If anyhow I will manage to prove that angle D, this angle, angle BDC is equal to angle BCD, if anyhow I manage to prove these two angles are equal. So I can say BD equals to BC. See how we find. With the adjacent property of triangle, yeah, 40 plus 30 is 70, 180 plus 70 is U, this angle. This is by still angle property. This is the extended side of AD. AC is the extended side of AD. So by still angle property, this extended angle must be 40 plus 70 plus 70 angle, which is 70. 40 plus 40 is 70. Okay. And another thing, in this one thing is given, it's like AB is equal to AC. Means these two angles are equal. These two angles are equal. So here in this question you have one angle is 30, 40 and AB equals to AC. And BD equals to BC, we have to prove. So here 40 degree, here 30 degree, this angle I have to calculate. And this angle is 100 degree, this angle is this both angles are equal. Suppose this angle is x. Because since AB is equal to AC. So this vertical angle is given. So I can calculate this equal angles. X. How? Now proof. Proof. Complete angle. B will be also x. C is x, the complete angle B will also be x because AB equals to AC. This is an isosceles triangle. So angle opposite to both sides are equal. So angle opposite to side AC is angle B, complete angle B, and angle opposite to side AB is angle C. Okay. So first you take any triangle ABC. Apply the angle property angle A plus angle B plus angle C equals to 180 AB. Now put the measurement angle A 40. Angle Vx, angle Cx. Like this you can calculate. Since angle, so here you got 2x equals to 140, 120 minus 40, 140. Now this this is 70 degree. This I got 70 degree. So now see. Now you can see. Now inclined BDC. Inclined BDC. Now inclined BDC. Now you can apply. But this is actually not 70 degree. Now inclined BDC. L equals to L equals to C, it is a 70 degree. Each 70 degree. Each 70 degree you got. This implies that. Side of the people and the side of the so this implies that B equals to BC. Proof. Okay. So this is all for today, students. In the next class, we will solve. So practice 11E. 11E. Okay.